Hey, my name's Kobe, and today's the big day. The day I face my fear of petting cats. I've been afraid of them since I was a kid, and about a week ago, I decided to take an online course with tons of tutorials on how to go about petting a cat. It actually offered quite a lot in the course, and even though the instructor was a bit of a kook.
So first you pet the cat with one finger in the middle of the cat, like this?
It was useful. I'm not just gonna be proving to myself that I can do it, but also to my subscribers. What it do, bugaboos? Today is the day. My hands are prepped and stretched. Let's do this. Okay. I can do this. 3, 2, 1. Turns out, it's not so bad. They're softer than I expected. All in all, it was a transformative experience that I'm glad I went through. Up next, dogs.
I hope you enjoyed that little sequence. I used MTracker 3D to track MTuber 3 and MTutorial titles to my shots. So let's break down one of those examples so you can learn how to track different motion VFX plugins of yours with MTracker 3D. Let's first work on this shot where a price tag pop-up was seen. That price tag pop-up is one of the many awesome options in MTutorial, so I'll go into my titles, head to MTutorial, and it's this option here, button 3. I'll trim off the end here by pressing Option and right bracket on my keyboard. For now, I'm going to use my on-screen controls to make this a little larger and place it in the general area that I want. We're going to be fine-tuning the size and position a little later. I want to make a few adjustments to this text before we move on, but to save you some time, I'm going to speed this part up. So now that that's done, let's head back up to the top, and I'm going to turn off the animation out so the price tag stays up for the rest of the duration of the clip. Once you've adjusted the title or the graphic the way you'd like, make the title into a compound clip. So you can right-click and click New Compound Clip, or press the shortcut Option G. Then click the clip that you want to track the title onto. Open your effects browser and either drag or double-click on MTracker 3D to apply. MTracker 3D is as easy as pressing this track button on the viewport here. You can also press track in your inspector window. Let me give you some quick tips while this tracks. MTracker 3D works best with high contrast, so if your shot doesn't have a lot of contrast, what you can do is just add a little bit of contrast into your shot, track the shot, and then you can delete that contrast adjustment. Also, it's important to make sure that your footage's frame rate is the same as your project's frame rate. So if your clip is 24 frames per second, then your project should be the same. So with this tracked, we're gonna go into our titles and search for MTracker 3D. And we're gonna find logo and drag it over our footage. Open your inspector window and we're gonna click the clip we tracked and select copy track. Then click the logo title and hit paste track. This logo title is now tracked to our shot, and what we're gonna do is use the drop zone in this title to apply our price tag pop-up here. So we'll click the drop zone, select the beginning of the compound clip here, and hit apply. Now we can just delete the compound clip from the timeline, and you'll see that the price tag is tracked in our shot. It's obviously small and not in the right position, but we will get to that in a second. Select this aim point here, and let's find a point to track onto. Because this shot is just a simple slide, I'm gonna hold shift, which will orient these points to be straight up and down. Now let's adjust the size and position. I'm gonna make it bigger here by adjusting the content scale so we can see it. You'll notice that it looks like we're cutting off the text, and that's because it's too large within the drop zone. So we'll decrease the logo inside scale so we can see everything again. Now we can start bringing the size up. I'll adjust the position here by adjusting the X and Y axis, and I'll go back and forth to find the right size. I'll raise the light intensity to brighten the text back up. And I want to turn off the shadows and instead go with a reflection to make it seem more realistic. You may turn this on and the reflection may not be visible. We'll need to head back up and make some adjustments so it'll show. What you'll want to do is adjust the logo position and scale back until you can see it. What happens is when we scale up the logo, the reflection gets farther from the title. and you can see it here. It's faint, but we'll adjust that. Let's adjust the falloff exponent and extend the end distance so we can see the whole thing. I'll increase this a little more, and we'll lower the amount of the reflection overall. I'll make some more adjustments to the position now that everything's in place. And if we play this back, it looks great. It's tracked really well, and the reflection adds a sense of realism to the title. Now let's throw a wrench in this example. So let's raise the scale. Say you want this larger. You'll notice the reflection now overlaps on the laptop. So here's what we'll do. Duplicate the track clip by pressing Option and dragging. Raise it above the logo title. Find the draw mask in your effects browser and drag it onto that copied clip. What we're going to do is essentially cut out the computer by making points around it, since the reflection was reflecting onto the computer. You can add a bit of feathering so that these two blend together a little better. Next, we're going to press our Control and Transform points so we can move and animate the mask, since the camera movement is sliding. So press all the points and move some frames and then adjust the mask. Move some frames and then adjust the mask, and so on. Because we press the keyframe buttons, all of our adjustments are saved and Final Cut will guess the path from one change to the next. And there we have it. Now the reflection looks as if it's showing behind the computer. And that is it. Let us know if you found this tutorial helpful by commenting below, and make sure to like and subscribe to get notified about all announcements for new releases and tutorials. We'll see you in the next one.